name is Chris Haggis with Low and Mean, and I want to tell you about our Low and Mean V-Star 950 that we built. We got this motorcycle about 7 weeks ago, and it was a non-stop mad dash to build you one of the coolest custom motorcycles that will accept bolt-on parts to get what you're looking at right here. I want to talk to you a little bit about what we did, like our 23-inch front wheel. We did a 23-inch front fender. We did a really cool custom chin scoop, a performance air intake. We got a cell buckle up here, custom speedometer. We did a dash cover, of course a lower C-pan, and this is where it gets really interesting. We got a beautiful long fender, and to complement that, we have a Leo Vince exhaust system. This bike came together beautifully. And we want to show you all the details on each one of these items. All right, let's take a little bit closer look at what we did. The front end here, we put a Ride-Rite spoke wheel from them, their blade spoke wheel in chrome with some Scotch-Brite sanding on it, so we give like a really cool contrast from chrome to sort of a satin finish. Then we designed our front fender around this wheel to fit perfectly with the 23-inch front wheel and had it mount to the V-Star 950 forks. We also installed a VTX Extreme 8-degree triple tree, which is also available in 6 degrees if you have the stock front wheel. Our Low and Mean chin scoop is a great addition to really bring that out of aesthetic look to your motorcycle while it's standing still. It makes it fast, makes it low, makes it mean, of course. Our performance air intake is an adapter that we designed, but we installed a Harley Davidson diamond cut air filter. Sort of has a diamond shape, but it has that traditional Harley-Davidson bolt pattern on it, so it'll fit on all of our performance air intake systems. The Leo Vince exhaust was absolutely beautiful. This exhaust is a very high quality. The chrome finish on it was spectacular. The fit was even better. The sound is amazing on this motorcycle. Complements everything we did with this motorcycle. It's almost like we built the motorcycle around the exhaust, and I'm very pleased with how that turned out. You'll see at the very end of the exhaust that we put a little copper screen in there to sort of go for our theme that I have going through the bike with copper screens. Right here you're going to see our lower C-pan. It also has a little addition here, which isn't sort of normal for our C-pans, but it is something we put on this motorcycle to kind of continue the lines from the gas tank. So we built this bra to go down into the seat and then onto our longer rear fender. And the rear fender you see here as well is absolutely a one of a kind. It is new from Low and Mean, and you're gonna see this on a lot of different models. So on our rear fender, we've integrated in a side bag with our rear fender. And we sunk in our Radiance LEDs to have running and brake and running and turn on the sides. Let me turn those on so I can show you how those light up. Not too shabby, I'd say. So you got a really good bright LEDs on both sides of the bike and really well in the center. You can see the license plate light lights up really well. Let me turn the turn signals here. See, we have turn signals flashing on both sides. And then of course, the center gets brighter when we hit the brakes. Behind this cover here, we've integrated in a storage compartment. We have about just over a gallon of storage in here. You can stick a coat in here, a small lady's coat or purse. You can probably put some tools, whatever you want to put in here. You definitely have some extra storage. So we've created all this to add more storage with a sleeker design, and it gives you the opportunity to win this V-Star 950 giveaway motorcycle from Low and Mean. One of the cool things about building this custom motorcycle and working around the stock platform is being able to integrate in other products from other motorcycles. We were able to bring in floorboards from the Roadliner, and I thought they worked quite well with what we did with our design here. So these are stock floorboards from the Roadstar Roadline and Roadline Deluxe. We got these great looking Jeffology Bomber Series covers, the Midnight Series covers you can find at Star Accessories at starmotorcycles.com. We also have just a few other little chrome accents we did. You can see here we have a chrome axle cover, which you can find at Low and Mean on the front and the rear. And a few other little button chrome areas that we did just to dress up the motorcycle. Here's a cool axle cover. This kit will be available from Low and Mean that you can buy for your V-Star 950. Also, here is our swing arm extension, which has a little bullet light at the end. This also is an item from Low and Mean. You'll see down here on the brake caliper is another piece of that Midnight Bomber Series cover that we got from Star Accessories. And then on the back of wheel here, you'll notice that it has a different rotor, which is from Ride Right Wheels, and the rear wheel matches the front wheel. Obviously, that is a must, and it looks gorgeous on this motorcycle. Also, might be a little bit hard to see, but we're running a car tire on this motorcycle. And the reason we went for a car tire is, well, two reasons. We wanted a real low profile tire to get the bike as low as possible. And then we wanted a tire that is a little bit flatter. The arc in it is a little bit more square. So at low speeds, the bike stability is amazing. So, and actually the handling at all speeds is really good with this tire. And we're quite pleased with putting this tire on this motorcycle. In all aspects, it seemed to work great. These bars are actually for a Harley Road Glide. You know, they have a certain bend that gets around their fairing. I really like the design. I want to use them on this motorcycle, and so we made them work. Obviously, the bars, they're from Burley. You can also buy them at Star Accessories. And a few other things that we did I think are nice and sleek is our little mirrors. We got these from Parts Unlimited. They're great little mirrors that give you that function and don't soak up so much of the design. We also have turn signal end grips, which the turn signals are here on the end of the grips, like you see, and also underneath the gas tank, which shine onto the chrome valve covers, or the engine covers, I should say, which give you two areas of turn signals for the front of the motorcycle. This is probably one of my favorite gadgets. I've been using it for about a month now. It's called the cell buckle. And this thing will hold your cell phone, it'll hold your GPS, maybe you have a Power Commander LCD screen. But it's as simple as putting it in. We have it connected to the 500 watt stereo system we have in this motorcycle. And also we put on a cigarette lighter so you can plug in your car charger to make this work. You'll see over here on the dash, it has just the normal speedometer, but we changed out the speedo face from Mojo, Biker Mojo. And they make speedometer faces for us. That you can get in many different designs. We made a carbon fiber inlay designs, which went with the rest of our carbon fiber looking theme here. We put a lower profile gas cap on here. And one of the reasons we wanted to do this is to get the gas cap nice and low so it's not as high as a stock one, but also with the design of our bars, we needed a lower profile gas cap so when you turn the bars, it would miss the gas cap. So. There's quite a few details going on this motorcycle. Maybe you won't catch in all the pictures, but I hope you get the chance to see this motorcycle at one of the bike rallies and be able to sign up to win this motorcycle from Low and Mean and Star Motorcycles. On the left side of the motorcycle, we had to change up the coil cover a little bit. This was a stock one. You can see that the shape and the size of it, and it actually stuck about this far off of the motorcycle. Wasn't really the direction that we wanted to go, so we went ahead and designed an all new one. It's made out of stainless steel. This one here you see has been powder coated, but the original or the normal version will come in a polished stainless steel finish. You'll be able to purchase this from Low and Mean or our dealers as well. And it's a great item that holds your coils, it cleans up the motor, and it really adds a little bit of that styling that maybe you're looking for that you didn't like in this thing here. Also, you can see on this side of the motorcycle is we have our bomber covers that we did. These are from Star Accessories, along with the floorboard, of course, from the Roadliner. One of our new Low and Mean items for the V-Star 950 is the lower chin scoop. We designed this to fit right in within the frame and to be a bolt-on item. We integrated in a copper screen just to the bottom, and we didn't put a screen in the front because we wanted to make sure everybody knew that this was an air-cooled motorcycle. So leaving this open didn't fill in the gap between the frame rails, and I think the overall appearance and how the scoop flows into the front fender was an excellent addition for this motorcycle or any motorcycle. If you have a V-Star 950 or any Star motorcycle, check out Low and Mean for more chin scoops that are available for what you ride.
Thank you for watching this video about the V-Star 950. We hope you'll subscribe to our YouTube channel so you can stay up to date on everything Low and Mean is doing. And when you get a minute, stop by our website, lowandmean.com, and sign up for our newsletter.